On Wednesday, the Supreme Court will hear long-awaited oral arguments on whether or not President Trump's travel ban discriminates based on nationality or religion. For more insight, let's bring in attorney and political analyst Gail Trotter and Elizabeth Wydra with the Constitutional Accountability Center. Ladies, thank you for joining me. I appreciate it.
Great to be here.
Great to be here.
Okay, so Gail, I want to start with you and get Elizabeth's response as well. The Cato Institute came out this week and they had really a gamut of security measures that they say already reduces the risk of terrorists coming into the country. And so that would probably go along with the lines of the fact that we don't need this travel ban. What is your response to that article and those findings that came out?
Right. Well, they're wrong because the primary power of the federal government is to make sure that the nation is safe. And under the Constitution, the president has broad power to make sure that he can exclude citizens who pose a risk under the national security power. And the judiciary is supposed to defer to the president's exercise of those broad powers, not based on what Cato says, but based on what the president feels is important. And he asked the heads of many agencies in the United States government to identify these countries that pose national security risks, and these are non-citizens of the United States from countries that pose national security risks.
All right, well, I'm curious to hear your response, because the Cato Institute will directly say, well, that's just not true.
Yeah, I mean, I think what the Cato Institute has found backs up what dozens of retired generals and admirals and national security experts have said in court in this case, that this ban does not make us safer. And in fact, it actually goes against our national security because it undermines key elements of our Constitution. The idea that we don't discriminate on the basis of religion, there cannot be a religious test at the border. That is un-American, unconstitutional, and unlawful.
But is this a religious test?
I think it is. And you know,
you disagree, Gail.
Obviously not. Many majority Muslim countries are not included in this executive order.
But Trump said
we're
talking to ban Muslims, and that's what he's done.
We're talking about the executive order that is before the Supreme Court. We're not talking about anything else. We're talking about
you're separating campaign speech and then the executive order. Is that what you're implying?
Right. Did
but you
he
can't.
Have the authority?
And some of those
no, you absolutely
were made
can.
During his presidency, and the Supreme Court has held over and over that when you're looking at whether a policy is discriminatory, you look at the context in which that policy was created. So that is why those statements by Trump himself are incredibly important to show whether or not he had discriminatory reasons for passing this travel ban. And it's clear that he does. It doesn't make us safer, right, and it goes against our primary fundamental American values and the statutes itself that govern immigration.
Does it make a difference that this is sort of travel ban 3.0, that we've seen sort of these revised visions and that they're looking at purely travel ban 3.0, if you will? And not only that, but it's been in place and it's been upheld by lower courts since it was passed. Does that have any...
So most of the lower
impetus.
Courts have actually found it to be likely to be unlawful. The Supreme Court has allowed it to go into effect while these legal challenges go on. But, you know, it's really the third verse, same as the first. There has been some cleanup. The first travel ban that went through caused extraordinary chaos and confusion. They've cleaned it up a little. But, you know, you can put all the legal window dressing you want on it. The fact is it's still unlawful and discriminatory.
You know, we believe that you should look at the law and you should be bound by the law. And
absolutely.
There's an answer for that if you don't like the policy prescriptions of a president, then you vote him out of office. It is not the judiciary's role to look behind the executive order. You look at the executive order, you see if it is valid on its face, and if the president has the authority. And he has the authority, particularly in this area where his powers are at the height under the Constitution. He also has statutory authority under the Immigration Naturalization Act to make these decisions.
So you're saying agree or disagree, he has the right. And I want you both to answer this. I want just sort of your predictions from both of you. I mean, I know we're not going to get the actual, you know, the final verdict, if you will, until June, but I'm curious as to what you both think.
Yeah, so I think the key point she said is whether the president has authority to do this.
Right.
And he doesn't. There is a 1965 statute. So yes, we look to the law, absolutely. I completely agree with you. There's a 1965 statute that says you cannot discriminate on the basis of nationality when it comes to immigration law. And the president, of course, while he does have broad discretion under immigration law, must be bound by the Constitution. That's not something you vote someone in or out of on their policies. The Constitution must apply to every single president in every moment of his presidency.
Do I hear you saying that Gorsuch is going to side with the liberals?
You know, I don't know. I mean, certainly if he follows his text and history focus as an originalist, he certainly should rule against Trump's travel ban. This will be a real test for his independence.
Gail, I want you to have the last word.
No, and it would be the opposite. I would say that he would uphold the separation of powers, the president's ability to do the most fundamental job of the federal government to keep the nation safe. And certainly, when you're talking about this, the findings in the past, President Reagan did this, President Carter did this. This is something that is done by presidents of both administrations, both political parties, and it is a core purpose of the Constitution to make sure that Americans don't have a suicide pact, that we can protect ourselves. And you can disagree with the policy, but the president in this case has not just himself, he's consulted with the heads of
I agree
agencies.
With the Constitution, and the Constitution says you can't do it. So
all right.
We'll see what the Supreme Court says.
We'll have you guys back maybe in June, because it was very interesting, and we love having you on. Thank you so much, Elizabeth. Gail, appreciate it.